If you've got an EV and you charge it at home using Octopus Energy's intelligent Octopus Go tariff, but you also have home batteries, then you may have noticed that when Octopus give you an extra off-peak session outside of your normal off-peak hours, that your home batteries get drained. Well, if you've got a GivEnergy battery, then I'm going to show you a simple home assistant automation that can help you out. So a few weeks ago, I had a call from Gary Does Solar, and he explained the problem he had and asked me if Home Assistant could solve it. So I gave him a shopping list of parts he needed to get Home Assistant up and running. Go and check out that video if you'd like to find out more about the hardware that I recommended for beginners who want to get started with Home Assistant. I'll put a link to that down in the description. Intelligent Octopus Go will always charge your car at off-peak rates. Any electricity used by your home at the same time is also billed at that low off-peak rate. So the aim with this automation is to detect when your car is charging and tell the batteries to charge at the same time. If the batteries are already full, then we want them to stay full while your car is charging, so as your car and home get off-peak energy rates. Then when the car stops charging, peak rates will apply, so we need the battery to jump back into dynamic or eco mode. Of course, you need to be with Octopus Energy first. If for some reason you are with another energy supplier and would like to switch to Octopus Energy to take advantage of one of their many smart tariffs, like Intelligent Octopus Go, then please use my referral code, which is on the screen right now. Once your switch has completed to them, then we'll each get £50 of account credit. But back to the automation. So thanks to a couple of members of the GivTCP Facebook group, there is already an automation available to do this. Thanks to the hard work of Greg and Willy, you can copy and paste their code into Home Assistant and tweak it to your needs. But I wanted something a little easier for beginners to use, so I've turned it into what's called a blueprint, which means you don't need to edit any code at all to get this working. But there are some restrictions over what my blueprint can and can't do. If you have an ohm charger, for instance, you'll need a totally different automation, and Willy has a version for you up on the Facebook group. Also, my blueprint only supports a single inverter, so if you have multiple inverters, then again, you'll need to go and check out Willy. There are also a few quirks you need to be aware of, because this solution is not perfect. It relies on Octopus sending a signal via their API to say when the off-peak sessions start and end. If that signal is delayed for any reason, then you could end up using a bit of peak energy to charge your batteries until the automation gets the signal to stop. There's also a bit of a built-in delay at the end of a cheap session before it stops the batteries charging, in order to try and catch delayed signals and avoid longer accidental peak charges. But the important thing is that these few minutes of peak use here and there are more than offset overall by the extra cheap sessions that you are getting. Okay, so this automation has some prerequisites. Firstly, you need to make sure that you have the Octopus Energy integration from BottleCap Dave installed and configured to communicate with your Octopus Energy account. You can install this using HACS, which is like a third-party app store for Home Assistant. You will also need to install an MQTT broker called Mosquito, which is available as an add-on in Home Assistant. Finally, you need to install GivTCP, which is an add-on that communicates directly with your GivEnergy inverter and sends data to Home Assistant using MQTT. I'm not going to go through configuring those prerequisites in this video. At the time of recording this, I don't have any tutorials for installing those components. All of the components have great instructions on their web pages though, and I'll put links to them in the description. For GivTCP, the newest version at the moment is version 3, which is the version that you should install. At some point, I'll do a proper video tutorial for that, and when I do, I'll put a link down in the description. So provided that you've got all the prerequisites installed and configured correctly, then installing this automation is actually really simple. You just go down to Settings, over to Automations and Scenes, and then choose Blueprints at the top. And now we click on this little blue Import Blueprint button that's down in the bottom right hand side, and it's going to ask you for a blueprint address. Now I'm going to paste in a URL here, and I will put this down in the comments, so don't worry, you can copy and paste it from there. This is basically just a URL to the code that's stored on GitHub, so you know, you can just paste into there and click on Preview. Now, if you want, you can have a look at the code by expanding the blueprint content section. So you can have a good look through there if you want to, but you don't need to. You just need to click on import blueprint there. Now, once the blueprint has been imported, you've got to create an automation from it. And we do that by just clicking on the blueprint itself. And we have two drop-down options here that we need to configure. So the first one is Octopus Intelligent Slot Active. And I've put some notes there to help you find this. But the idea is you basically just need to find a sensor called Intelligent Dispatching. So I'm going to type in Intelligent Dispatching there, and you can see it's listed just here. The second one is GivEnergy Enable Charge Schedule Entity. So this is from the GivTCP add-on, and it ends in enable_charge_schedule. So enable_charge_schedule. And you can see it's this first one in the list right here. Now, if you're wondering why I've blurred stuff out there, that's because I don't want to show you the serial numbers or account numbers that are on the screen right now. But if I click on save, it'll ask me to give it a name, and I'll accept that name, and that's it. So I'm going to go back a step, and I'm going to go to the automations tab there, and you can see here that there is one automation on Home Assistant installed called IOG GivEnergy Inverter Control version 1, and this little blue toggle box is turned on, so that means it's enabled and running, so everything is all ready to go now. And that's it. You now just need to keep an eye on when your car and batteries are charging to make sure it's working. This automation has been tested with a GivEnergy hybrid inverter and a Zappy charger. So if you have different devices, then you might get different results. If you want to see Gary's side of this story, where he's going to talk about his experience with getting the hardware set up and living with this automation, then check out his video, which I'll put a link to down in the description. Anyway, I hope you found this useful. If you did, then please give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe for free to see more from me. A massive thank you to my patrons and channel members listed here for supporting me. If you'd like to support the channel by becoming a patron or channel member, then check out the links in the description. In return, I'll give you early access to my videos and some bonus content too. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.